Alright, our very first game of the night is Half-Life. Half-Life is our first game of the night. And we're going to go with Jesse. Give Jesse a round of applause. And you are going to be jamming with Stephanie. Where's Stephanie at? Stephanie raised her hand. She's never been to an improv show before. You're about to jump into a lot of fun here. All right. All I want the two of you to do, so just know, Stephanie, that in an improv scene, you just do what you would normally do. You don't even have to try to be funny. We're humans. Humans are naturally dumb, funny people. So just be human. And in this scene, I'm going to ask you guys to do a one-minute scene, okay? And we'll get an activity, we'll get a suggestion from the audience. You guys will perform this scene. Jesse is really not good at improv, so it's a bad partnership. we're going to do a one-minute scene. We're going to get an activity. You guys are going to act that out for about a minute or so. I'll call scene. Simple enough, right?
Changing a light bulb.
Changing a light bulb, Hunter. Changing a light bulb. And this is Half-Life.
Becky, bitch. You said you would change your light bulb this month. It's your job this month. I don't even see a light bulb that's on. I don't know what they're talking about. Get up there. It's way up there. I don't see it. All right, fine. I'll do it. I'm doing everything in this relationship. It's ridiculous. I want to stop it now. Okay. Can you hand me the light bulb? You didn't say everything light bulb. Oh, my gosh. Becky, you're the worst. Okay. Wait, no, maybe it's not out. Maybe the switch is just off. Okay, go try the switch. Where? Oh my god, it's on! There's light! Oh wait! There's light! Oh my god, wow, we're a such a great team!
Yeah, so we're still gonna charge them full price, right?
Yeah, obviously. Exactly. But yeah, that was really cool. I'm glad we did that.
So, in this world of YouTube, where we don't have time to watch one-minute scenes, I'd like to see you guys do that same exact scene in half the time. So, same exact scene, 30 seconds, go!
Becky, bitch! Get up. Oh my god, it's broken!
No, it's not broken, it's just out.
Oh, right. Can you try turning on a light?
Yeah.
Oh my god, it worked!
I'd really like to see this in like an Instagram type of situation. Same scene, 15 seconds. Go!
Becky, you bitch! The light is broken!
No, it's not out!
Get it! Fix it!
Same scene, 7.5 seconds. Go!
Let me finish! Light bulb out!
No, it's just on!
Switch on! It's burning!
Scene! I just wonder what the essence of the scene is. 3.75 seconds. Go! Forward reverse. And in this game, we I guess guess our improviser is going to be Barry. Barry's wearing a deer in headlights on this. And the improviser, the jammer with him is going to be Adam. Where's Adam at? These guys are like, we've never been here before. Why would you do this to us? Hi, Adam.
Yes.
Good. What's your relation to Stephanie? How do you know Stephanie?
I am her.
Yeah, they're married. Yay. Okay. In this game, I hold an imaginary remote control. Okay? So what that means is if I say reverse, it means that the scene that you've done up to that point is going to stop, and you will now have to do that scene in reverse until I say forward, and then you will do that same exact scene back up to the point where you were and continue creating a new scene. Now, we're going to test this out a little bit. We're going to play the game a little bit so that you guys can just see how that works. So the two of you just start to have a nice conversation, right? You're at a bagel shop, and you guys are really enjoying the cream cheese. Talk about that for just a second.
I got this new jalapeno cream cheese right here.
Yeah, it's weird that they call it a schmear, but I don't love it.
I know, it's completely fabulous, but schmear, where do you think that came from?
Reverse. And then Barry would do the line that he just gave.
So where do you think the schmear came from?
I don't know, but it's got a lot of jalapeno.
Jalapeno is the type of schmear this is.
This is going to be a trick. Location could fit right here on the stage.
Brooklyn Water Bagel.
A what?
Brooklyn Water Bagel.
Brooklyn Water Bagel?
Brooklyn Water Bagel.
Okay, so we're going to stick with bagels. Alright, so we're going to be a Brooklyn Water Bagel. That's where your scene is going to take place. The thing that is the most helpful in this game is if the two of you are active, doing a lot of activity in the scene that helps you remember what's going on in the scene. May not help your soul. Here we go. You're at the Brooklyn Water Bagel Company, and go.
You've been to this Brooklyn Water Bagel before?
Yeah, I trained like 20 minutes every single
time. Worst Brooklyn Water Bagel there's ever been in South Florida.
Ooh, some ice cream.
Some ice. Oh, let's get those.
Oh, throw some in my cup. They left mine a little warm. Oh, I want iced coffee. Here we go.
Suicide coffees?
Oh, okay. Oh, it's my heart rate just a little bit. I know, I know I'm not awake until I have a little bit of heartburn.
Reverse!
I know I'm not awake until I have a little bit of heartburn.
Yeah, and I don't know, I like this suicide.
You gotta commit suicide while you're drinking water.
Our next game we're going to play is Party Words. We need Leandra. Come on down. I have no idea what's about to happen. This is Party Quirk. So this is a game where we're gonna have a party. Nick, you're late. You need to go get shit for your party. So you need to get out. And young lady, will you just make sure that you can't hear anything? Just go step out there because I want to make sure.
I'll just jump on that cover.
That's impressive. All right. What's happening with that young lady? I think I picked the right security person. Alright, so the way this game is going to work is we have a party court. So Nick's about to host a party, and in this party, his guests are weird. And that's nothing against the three of you. Your characters are weird. So the first character that's going to show up is, he's got a weird fear. Can have a really odd fear, but not like a fear of heights
or squids.
Pickles.
Say fear of double tears. Shameless character has a fear of folding chairs. Right? Now here's the thing before we get too far. We can't say folding chairs. However, if Nick begins to guess close to it, like you have a fear of furniture, you guys can be like, can I do that? And if Nick gets it, if Nick says, oh, you got a fear of folding chairs, you guys would go, yay! Right? Let's hear that. Yay! Now, Sam here has he's got a weird occupation. But it's not like a gynecologist or a pilot or something like this. What's a really weird occupation he has?
Water engineer!
Making dildos.
A crane operator.
Convenient.
Live air trainer.
What's that? That's a weird one. Sam, you're a hand model. Hand model is the word we're looking for. However, if I hear Nick talk about hand jobs, that would be hilarious. And my mind just went blank for a second. So, Party Quirks. What's
life for you?
Celebrity. Wait, Leandra, you're going to be an impersonator. All right, so what celebrity is
Elvis?
Justin Bieber.
I heard Elvis. Oh. Do you know any Elvis songs?
Do you know who Elvis is?
No.
Elvis Costello next. All right, so you can get there he is. Occupation, celebrity. I will remind Nick of that as well. It's probably been a day or two since he's played that game. So just know that as they approach, you know, ooh, and if they get an applaud, please don't help them by saying the word. Ugh, that hurts so much. And we kill people. So you guys need to get out because you're inside Nick's house right now. So if you guys can sweep on over, you guys can just come on over right over there. And then on the count of three, we're going to say come on in for Nick so he knows to come back in here. One, two, three.
Come on in!
And then I'll go get him. All right. Dude, Nick, you'd be late. Oh, God.
I'm so sorry.
Yeah, man.
Flat tire. So stole my tire.
I know. I just want to let you know as your party planner that you got weird guests. Okay? And just remember that one person's going to have a fear, and one person's going to have an occupation, and then one person, you might have a celebrity. But otherwise, this party's weird, and I'm definitely not checking in on Facebook. But enjoy. Your chips are gross.
Yeah, it has.
How are the kids?
You know,
Billy still missing the leg?
Oh, no. I think so.
It's not really, it's not going to down.
Yeah, so your snack table.
Oh, right.
It doesn't look very sturdy, but, okay.
No, I just replaced one of the legs last Tuesday, so it's fine.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So it's like one you own, you haven't, like, buy it just for today or.
Oh no! Long track record of rent-a-center, but
okay.
I bought this one. I bought this table.
Okay.
Try the carrot then. It's to die.
Is there like a? This is, yeah. I'll turn you back. All right. Cool.
Do you know Mr. Pid?
Yeah, the Pid.
I got you.
Okay.
You probably got it. Yes, got it.
I'll just stand for a while.
Oh, yes, hello.
They're here.
No pictures, please. No pictures. No pictures.
Good.
Do you...
Sorry.
Oh, Becky, this is... Hello. Hey, this is Kirk.
Hi.
No, it's okay. It's alright.
Do
you want to smell them?
No, I don't. I maybe straighten them out a little bit.
They are straight. Like this?
Yes.
That's straighter for you?
Yeah.
Wow.
It's a lot better.
Do you have any cocaine? I don't like to put my hands to.
I just finished my last 8-ball this morning. It was one of those days.
Is there something wrong with
you? Oh, you might have another guest.
Yeah.
I was like, oh, I'm serious.
Look how professional we are.
1, 2, 3.
Do you know what Sean is?
Yeah.
Hello.
Chick. Hey guys, alright. So for this one, we're gonna play a game called Sound Effects. Oh. Yeah. In Sound Effects, first of all, your GMer, it's gonna be Matt. Who's Matt? Matt, come on! That's pretty much perfect. Great. So, you were going to play in this scene with Charles. Where's Charles at?
Boom.
Wow. See, if you hear that noise, that's the soul of my father. impressive. Yeah, better throw this in the dump. It's a very deep garbage can. It's a deep garbage can.
What do you do
with the other half? Fix it up. That's what we do, Alan. That's what we do.
All right, I'll open up the hood. Will you help me?
Oh, absolutely.
All right, let me get the hinge. It's a little rusty here.
Okay, I got it. Where are we? It's heavier on my edge.
Wait a minute. Where did you do it?
Hi, Dad. Dad, I hope I'm making you proud of you.
Yeah.
Here's your favorite smoothie. I'm going to make it for you. Sorry, that sound always makes me happy on the inside. Open up, Father! He's a thirsty man.
So, our theory is that soap operas are the same in every language, and we're about to find that out right now. Can we just get a suggestion of something that could have just happened?
It's my brother.
From not one of the cast members, it's with the audience.
They just found out they're twins.
Ooh, someone just found out that they're twins, and this is International Soap. No! I can't believe it.
I've been in a coma.
I couldn't keep it from you any longer.
I probably were just visiting because he was a family friend, but no, he was my twin. The fact that he was bald didn't go with me.
I want you to live a normal life without knowing that you have a sick brother. He could have died. I didn't want that on your life forever.
Look, I don't want to be your twin either. But obviously, it's the reality of the situation.
Freeze! France.
Well, I wasn't saying no because I didn't want you. I was just in shock. But if you don't like me, then that's something we're gonna have to wait for.
Yes, how do you explain?
You can
love my friend. Freeze! Spain. I just wanted to say. Yeah, when I go to college, he's not going to be my roommate.
Take those horns off your head, you're confusing me.
Horrible death.
Drop Marjorie and all of them.
Someone just drop Marjorie. And go.
I told you again, I can't believe it's not butter spray.
Questionably, they're relatively new pants.
whole food?
To the semen.
Salt.
Totally disgusting. I am your cousin.
It's underdone.
Very much not underdone. You just don't use semen on your pants. Bleach.
I mean, there's more right here. Spread that. A lot.
Zoologist! I wanted to be a zoologist! I didn't want to be a bleachologist.
Abstractly, I thought you studied abstract expressionism.
But I love the animals, you know? This disgusting.
Crazy how many animals there are, right? Like, why did God make all the animals?
Do you even know how many animals are in my soul?
$104.50. Truth be told, I'm gonna round down. So it'd be $104 to go with. So we got that. Great, great, great. Thank you so much for bidding on the silent auction stuff. We'll get to that at the end of the show here. Let's continue with the show, guys. All right, our next piece is Survivor. Survivor. That's a new fun one of ours. We need Val. Come on down. Hi, Val. We need Joy. Where's Joy at? We need Ken Berry. We need Jody. Hi, Jody. That's all right. I didn't call your name at the beginning, but I knew your name was here. You can blame Charles. And we need Linda. Where's Linda? All right, guys. So in this particular piece, what's going to happen is you're going to be in a group scene. So we need a location that could fit right here on the stage. Where should that be?
Strip club. Space station.
A strip club on the space station. For the strip club on the space station, it doesn't mean that all four ladies have to be strippers. That's fine. You don't need to do that. But you are at a gentleman's club on a space station. You don't all have to enter the scene at once. You can take your time. You can let it develop whatever you like. And then I'll call the scene when I feel like the scene is done. Have a lot of fun. There can be no wrong answers. You've got Linda and Ken. Raise your hands, Linda and Ken. Linda and Ken are here to save you and help you. So you are in a gentleman's club on a space station, and this is Survivor. Go.
Many aliens coming. Many, many aliens, they're coming.
How's my hair look?
Oh, it's fantastic, but I think we're all gonna die. Calm down.
You're supposed to protect us, right?
I can't protect you, I'm protected.
Oh, I like aliens.
I'm scared of aliens.
I like aliens.
Are you
I didn't know we were gonna die.
How do you say that?
How are you being so calm and everything's going on? Weird.
And see! I hate to do this, but we really are. We can't pay one of you any more than we paid already. And so
it's always okay.
No, Ken.
You get
to stay. But you know what? We gotta say goodbye now. Yeah, I'm sorry. So now you're missing two of your characters in the scene, but guess what? All three of you have to play all five characters perfectly.
go!
I don't know.
I like him.
Isis is really weird.
Let's get glittered up.
I bet aliens really love some weird. I came here to the space station. I didn't know there was going to be death.
I ain't talking. We're going to be okay.
How are you people so calm? This isn't cool.
Can't let them hear. Yarmulke is a very free-flowing type of a montage of scenes that can kind of have nothing to do with each other. However, we'll be inspired by a monologue. So if you feel so inspired, you might hop up and talk about something for a minute or so, completely off the top of your head, and then step back, and we'll just start to play along in scenes. If you're completely lost and out of sorts, Rebecca and I will totally guide you through this whole thing and make you look like rock stars. So, don't worry, because you're probably better than we are. So, we're going to get a word to start with. Rebecca's going to kick us off with a monologue, and as soon as she's done, we're going to hop in and do some scenes. Ken, if you would cut this somewhere around 6.
6 minutes? Cool.
Yeah, please. Great, thank
hours,
you.
Please.
6 hours. We'll be going for 6 to 8 hours.
I just need a word, any word at all. So I went to sleepaway camp, typical Jewish girl. And we had a field trip once to see the movie Jurassic Park. I know it's not Jumanji, but I did some word alliteration there. So saw Jurassic Park in the movie theater, and sitting next to me was our foreign exchange camper. She was from Germany, and she didn't understand anything that was happening in the movie, like, you know, verbally, but obviously when giant dinosaurs are shaking the earth, she was freaking out, and she was holding on to me so tight and like squeezing my arms anytime something scary happened, and I didn't know how to tell her to like get the fuck off of me because I didn't speak German, and I was like losing the feeling in my arm, but I was trying to be nice because she was the exchange camper, and that's my Jumanji story.
Hey.
been that day, and like how long I've been without washing.
It's all wrong. First, you gotta take off. You gotta take off your shoe and act like you own the place.
Oh, like Die Hard.
Yeah. About midway into Act Two, that's when you take a sock off.
So tell us about your date. How was it?
Well, I decided that I really, really liked it because I was gonna open myself up. So I gave a couple tests, like did a little bit of a grab for.
That's what you're.
Oh yeah.
See
how you reacted.
The pick and roll.
Yeah, like kind of sly, and then like hack a couple meetings, kind of like literally.
Oh, good.
Cool about it.
Has he called you yet?
He has sent me a text, and I asked him to do this. I was like, you ever have a sis? Did you find it? You sent it to me.
Oh my god.
Speaking one-on-one with a stranger, or speaking in large groups, or just talking on the telephone, or just sounding cooler. No, it does not make you sound cooler at all. But it makes you care a hell of a lot less about what other people think about you. Because we need you, and we need the best version of you. And once we know you, you are a plus to us. You are adding value to us. And once we see that you are gone, and then you are less than, there's no more neutral. So just in being on our stage tonight has been a real treasure and a lot of fun. And I hope you enjoyed it as much as I have. So consider taking a class. January 2nd, take a chance on yourself. January 4th is our stand-up comedy class. Whereas improv is, I love everyone, and it's beautiful and wonderful. Stand-up is horribly difficult and hard. And you will hate yourself. And that's generally stand-up comedians for the most part. They hate themselves. I'll be teaching that class and showing you just how much they hate yourself. And then January 5th, we start our sketch comedy writing, which is the sketches you can see on Saturday Night Live or Second City. or a lot of the web series, and that'll be taught by Barry. So, so those are the classes we have starting. We have shows every single Saturday night. We sure hope that you had so much fun tonight that you might even consider buying an annual pass or coming and seeing shows on a regular basis. So there's my little shameless plug. But we hope you're having fun tonight. We're certainly having a blast. I'm going to show you guys just how much you can do when you're scared out of your mind. We're going to make these guys come up with jokes on the spot. Yes. Where's Sophia? I messed up. I missed Sophia. How about that? Great. Sophia, we're going to have you up here, and after we do this bit, then we're going to have you do
a...
No, you're gonna get that's fear. It's fine. We'll work through that. So Sophia will be doing a piece after this as well. So that's my fault. Sorry about that, guys. So what we need to know is an occupation. What's any occupation that could exist?
Plumber.
I heard plumber. Now, if you guys feel so inspired, you just hop right out in the front and give me the world's worst plumber right now.
Oh, I love my high-waisted pants.
I think it's around here somewhere.
You know what? It's not that bad.
I have a suggestion of a location that you might find a lot of people gather.
Naked beach.
I'm sorry, I heard something from over here.
A naked beach.
A naked beach. These are things you never hear on a naked beach. Any things you never hear on a naked beach. Come on out.
Wow, he's so young and sexy.
You know they make cream for that.
No, it's an inverted piece. It goes inside.
Great. So many dick jokes. You got what you wanted. Can I get a suggestion of a movie genre?
Drama.
I heard drama. These are things you would never hear in a dramatic movie.
Oh, I'm so happy she told me.
Do what you want to the girl, but leave me alone.
Yay. I wish I saw more penis here.
We'll get a suggestion of of another place you might find a lot of people gathered.
Restroom.
I heard a restaurant. I heard a restaurant or a restroom?
Restaurant.
A restaurant. Things you'd never hear in a restaurant.
I love roaches.
Why can't they put more tables next to the restrooms?
Food poisoning every time. Good cleansing diet.
$15 for a martini?
And see, let's get
I got in there with you.
Alright guys, ladies and gentlemen, we just need, Sophie and I just need a suggestion of a location where we might be anticipating a meeting with people.
Church!
Church. We're going to be meeting somebody at a church. Ken, give us about five.
We'll do.
Great, thank you.
Minutes. Hours.
Years.
Eons.
Big day.
I know. My baptism. Oh. RCCA was a rough ride. Two ex-wives. Two.
Man, I think that goes against the Bible.
I know. And you know, and not all I need is Jesus' warm hands on me. He's really taught me.
Well, I think he's coming. So I think he's
if he's coming, then I'm coming.
I feel like you've got, there's a lot of innuendo that's in your prayer.
A little bit. I know. That's my problem.
It's just tough. So I feel like a lot of the prayers make it kind of into the stratosphere. They get filtered.
Right.
And then there's a lot of disrespect that the big guy is listening to.
You know what? You're right. Call me out. Call me out. And that's why. That's why my two wives love me.
I'm sorry, did you say two wives?
Two wives. My two wives, they both married and they left me. They took me to the RCCA class.
Can we, what's the RCCA? Can we talk about that for a second?
Religious Catholic Catholic Association.
Two Catholics?
Yes.
Man, that's a lot of Catholics. There's nothing in the handbook. Not a thing in the handbook. Goodness. Not a word that's in here.
Father.
Just call me John.
Father John.
Okay.
I know that I hide behind my innuendos and my jokes.
Oh, yeah.
But I really want to receive them. I want to receive them. I want to receive my wives. I want to receive myself. I want to all four of us.
Is there tracking numbers that go with this? That's a lot of perception.
Here at my baptism, I know it was a personal, private one, but I was hoping that
I have a lot of questions. First of all, there's a lot of stuff that if I did to earn the baptism, there's like a flowchart inside of the bank, right? And most of the flowchart said just don't marry other people of the same sex. That was mostly the thing.
True. Strike one. But to reconcile, if you don't mind, I invited both my ex-wife's wives.
Here they are now.
Thank you.
won't get a chance to play. Great. I'd like to give another round of applause for our jammers. Let them hear it. Brand new to improv tonight, or really never seen a show. There's a few people that played up on our stage tonight that don't necessarily improvise with Sick Puppies Comedy. They improvise with Improv U up in Del Rey. You might see them with Mod 27 up in West Palm Beach. You might see them play 4x4 with Greg Filippi down in Fort Lauderdale, or Got You Laughing down in Fort Lauderdale, or down at Fill-In all the way down to Miami.
Woo-hoo!
Or Just the Funny down in Miami, or at Improv South Miami, down south there. What else am I missing? Who else am I missing? I got them all. Yeah. So the key is that this stuff is happening all the time, all over the place, and we certainly love that you come and frequent us, but the best way to experience improv is to see the whole family of improvisers down here in South Florida, because they are incredible. The wealth of talent is unbelievable, and you don't have to come see shows in a call center all the time. So we certainly appreciate that. Before we let you go, first of all, who is going to win $104? We'll find out in a second. But congratulations to the package, the booze package, if you will, that's got the Jameson and the Guinness and all the Guinness stuff in there. Big round of applause to Matt Olk, everybody. Who's Matt? It's the same improviser, Matt! Yeah! So Matt, stick around after the show and come grab me, Matt, and you can get me some money. Why not? Feeling a little generous tonight. So three people made bids on classes tonight. We have Jeff and Charles and Nina. Jeff got the winning bid tonight for $110. That is a big deal. So Jeff, you get our classes for over 50% off, and that's killer. And because of that, Jeff, we're also going to provide you with some annual passes as well. Now, Charles won the annual passes piece there at a $70 bid, and we thank you so much for the generous offer there. So, Charles, you are going to receive a year's worth of annual passes for two, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to double that for you, Charles. So, you'll get four passes for the year, so you can bring four people with you to come see every single show. It's about $1 a show. Per person. So congratulations to you, Charles. So that means a lot to us. We had raised close to $600 even before we opened the doors tonight. There's a handful of you guys in here that went ahead and gave us donations ahead of time. You know who you are. Every dollar counted. It certainly means a lot to me. It's even though the name of my company is Sick Puppies Comedy, I'm all about dogs. And anyone that knows me knows that I love dogs more than I love people. Because, man, they're the coolest. They're unconditional love. So we had $600 ahead of time. We'll have at least 100 coming from this raffle going there. And then we raised another, help me out, guys, $240. So we got close to $1,000 tonight, guys. Give yourselves a hand. All right, now if you bring the house lights up, please, Ted, so people can look at their tickets. We will have you, sir. You just pick the ticket out of there. And that ticket number is 193867. Hey, Charles! It's confirmed it's not fraudulent. Charles is one. All right, I owe hope you guys had a blast tonight. If you really enjoyed yourselves and want to listen to us be a bunch of assholes in front of a microphone, we'll be down.